I've been using cerabone from the very beginning, and I had a very good experience. There are different kinds of way in which we use this grafting material in bone augmentation inside the envelope of bone and bone augmentation outside the envelope of bone. This material has been one of my favorite materials because it can maintain the volume when we do bone augmentation. Now, compared with other known bone grafting material, the stability of the material and its osteoconductive properties are very well documented, and we have very good clinical experience over time. Cerabone is a space maintaining material with very good osteoconductive properties. When we do bone augmentation inside the envelope of bone, we can mix the material with allograft, like max graft or autogenous bone or other allograft. When we graft outside the envelope of bone, we want to maintain the volume over time. And that's why a mixture of cerabone, which is space maintaining, with the allograft, which is resorbing and gives space for autogenous bone for regeneration of the bone, is a very good material. In some indications, cerabone can be used by itself without mixing it with any material, like example in the sinus augmentation, or after extraction in socket preservation, we can use cerabone by itself. What I'm doing right now, I'm trying to get rehydration of this material. Usually I do this before I start surgery, especially when in combination with the allograft or by itself. I try to rehydrate the materials before I do the surgery. So we wait 10 to 15 minutes before we apply this material into the receptive site. As cerabone comes in two particle sizes, we prefer for the 0.5 to 1 millimeter size for GBR. The bigger particle size, if we want to use it, we do it only in big augmentation or sinus augmentation. Usually, when we use in a sinus augmentation, we have to wait for 6 months. If we do socket preservation, we wait also 4 to 6 months before we can place the implant. But if we mix the material with allograft or with autogenous bone, then the time of changing from allograft to autogenous bone is reduced, so we can place our implants after 4 months.